स्वभाव चिन्मयानन्दं कृपापूर्णं जगत्पतिं हरिषड्वर्गजेतारं नित्यानन्दगुरुं भजे.
The seven layers, I think you can show the seven layers once more, maybe for the people who have come inside newly, for them the TV, how they say that, headlines once more. Once more, the headlines. The physical layer, the body out which, the physical body is the first layer. The prana movements is second layer. The inner chattering is third layer. Emotions are fourth layer. The deep sleep, what you experience during deep sleep, that silence is fifth layer. In the deep meditation, what you experience, that joy, that intense, vibrant silence is sixth layer. Enlightenment is seventh layer. In the deep sleep, it will be graveyard silence, negative silence. In meditation, it will be intense silence. There is a big difference. When you fall asleep and come back, you will not become more intelligent. But when you fall into meditation and come back, you will be more intelligent and you will be more blissful. When you fall asleep and come back, you may be fresh or a little relaxed, but you will not be more blissful. But when you fall into meditation and come back, that silence is called intense silence, live, vibrant silence. So, the seven layers, we store different samskaras in different layers. Usually the samskaras related to desire are stored in the prana, the breathing. And the samskaras related to chronic fatigue or tiredness is stored in the body, the physical body. That is why 2-3 times you try to do some exercise, workout or even walking, first thing body will bring out is tiredness. But without bothering about that first level samskaras which are raising, if you enter into it, suddenly you will see that same action brings energy out of you. If you start walking, in 2 minutes your mind will suggest 10 times, I am tired. No, no, it is too much, enough. We did, today it is okay, tomorrow we can do. It will try its best. But if you don't bother about that samskaras and just go ahead, in few minutes the same action will bring energy. Chronic fatigue means a deep feeling to be in inaction, to be in rest or non-moving or not moving is stored in the physical body. I always tell people, karma palatyaga, not karmatyaga. The results of the action should be surrendered, not the action itself. Karmatyaga is very easy. That is where the whole spirituality has ended. The worst thing happened to India is not our tradition, not following our tradition, not following what Krishna said, not following what our traditions have presented, but constantly I am seeing the superficial analytical reports. These fellows go on abusing. The other day I was reading an article, there was a technical term they started using, Hindu rate of growth. I was surprised. I was surprised. It's just, he means the suffering of India is because of our tradition. It is not. Suffering of India is because we did not follow our tradition. We did not imbibe our tradition. Instead of doing karma palatyaga, we started doing karmatyaga, stuck in the first layer. stuck in the physical layer itself. I've seen in the villages, many places, there are some great things in the villages. There are some things like, instead of karma balatyaga, karma tyaga, like till morning 10 o'clock you will see tea shops will be filled, people will be sitting and talking. If you want to listen to the great Vedantic truths, go to the village tea shops morning 10 o'clock. You will see there people will be sitting and just sipping the tea. Oh, without God's grace, nothing can be done. Only by God's grace anything can happen. All great truths, but just to justify what they are doing, not to internalize. Karma palatyaga is supposed to be the truth. But the karma tyaga starts happening if you are stuck in the physical layer. The chronic fatigue or intense craving for the rest. I have seen people, understand, this intense craving for the rest brings diseases which will put you in the bed. Intense craving for disease, craving for the rest. Actually, if you see any advertisement for resorts, beach resorts especially, if you see a photograph, beautiful beach, easy resting chair, and somebody resting. The moment you see that, immediately something starts happening in you. You feel you should also be lying like that, completely resting, totally in peacefulness, in the deep peace. The moment you see that, something in you is awakened. That's what I call intense craving for tamas. Understand? If you really find out the same beach, same chair and lie down, you will not have that same peace which you visualized. Till you exhaust the tamas engrams, lethargic engrams you carry in the physical layer, you cannot rest. Your desire for rest will not let you rest. Please understand. How can you say, Swamiji, my desire for rest will as naturally as to let me rest? No, it won't. Because it is from engrams. It is from samskara. Even if you find out the same beach, same chair, same bench, same place, try to lie down. The moment you rest, the moment you started resting, in few minutes this samskara will settle down, the next layer samskara will start. Even the decision to rest, if it is based on samskara, you cannot rest. First layer samskara is intense desire for rest. Continuously you will see your mind is pulled back. There is a very beautiful story in Upanishad. Disciple goes to the master and asks, Master, give me the method for enlightenment. Master says, very wonderful story. He says, just take these 400 cows, and when they become 1000 cows, come back. The modern day disciple would have said, what, you are making 600 cows out of my enlightenment. You are trying to make more cows out of my seeking. But he is really sincere disciple. He did not bother about it. He just took the cows. And the story says, when the cows have become 1000, when he came back, master says, not only he became enlightened, he says, now we have 1001 cows. In Vedic tradition, cows are highly respected as a sacred thing. He says, this guy is also now raised to that level, sacred, the level of sanctity. Actual thing, what happened is, continuously when you work with cows, they cannot let you rest. And they don't know you are working 24 hours. They don't know there is nobody else to replace you. They don't know that today is holiday. They don't know But one person can work only 8-hour shift. They do not have all these problem. They will constantly demand your attention. This guy, by working continuously with them, the desire, the deep desire for rest has disappeared. I can say, the deep desire for vacation or the deep desire for rest, the chronic fatigue, if it leaves your system, 90% of your spiritual journey is over. That is the first worst problem. First layer samskara. The second, in the prana sarira, in the pranic layer, you store all the desires. That is why whenever your desires are changing, suddenly you will see the breathing pattern will change. If you are caught by strong desires, like a lust or anger, even anger is a kind of a desire. Strong desires, your breathing pattern will change. It will be chaotic. The third layer, mental layer. See, the pranic layer, second layer, you store your thoughts about how your life should be. In the mental layer, you store your engrams about how your life shouldn't have been. Means guilt. If your energy moves towards the future, it is desire. If your energy moves towards the past, and continuously it is rotating only about the past, it is called guilt. If it is flowing continuously towards the future, it is desire. If it is flowing continuously towards the past, it is guilt. Different ways of moving. The mental layer, the third layer, you store the engrams related to guilt. The fourth layer, in emotions, you store all the visualizations related to pain. Understand, the fourth layer is very powerful layer. In the fourth layer, you don't need any action or information to strengthen the engrams. In the first two layers, you need action to strengthen your engrams. Means the tiredness or the desire for vacation. The more you give the vacation, the more the desire will be strengthened. Same way, other desires, the more you enter into action based on those desires, the more the engrams will become strong. The third layer, guilt, guilt-related engrams. You don't need to do the same action, but just the information about that action. Means, if you have seen the same place, or if you are seeing the same person, if you are seeing the same situations, immediately that engrams will become strong and it will be awakened. But in the fourth layer, pain engrams. First layer, chronic fatigue, lethargy engrams. Second, desires. Third, guilt. Fourth, pain. The pain layer, neither you need action, means you don't have to have the same pain again and again, nor you need information related to pain. You don't even need to receive informations related to pain. Just the engrams are enough, they can multiply. They can expand. They can multiply. The deeper layers, the fifth layer, the layer you experience, the deep sleep. There, even though engrams are there, you cannot do anything about it. Because in the deep sleep, your mind cannot do anything. It's an unconscious layer. In the first four layer, if you can reduce the depth of the engrams, samskaras, naturally the fifth layer and sixth layer will be cleansed. Fifth layer will be cleansed if you clean all the first four layer. If the fifth layer is cleansed, you will start experiencing sixth layer more and more. Sixth layer, meditation layer. Fifth layer is deep sleep layer. Sixth layer is meditation layer. If you are getting into the deep sleep layer more easily, it means the first four layers are clean. If the first four layers are not clean, then you will suffer more in the fifth layer. That is why the more stress and load, so much of suffering related to sleep starts happening in the life. Sleep has become a big problem. Now, especially in the developed countries, I am seeing they are able to get beds but not sleep. Their infrastructure has created the facility to have beds and different temperature, different comfort, so many things, but not sleep, because too much stress. Not only that, if these four layer engrams are too much, in the fifth layer, the relationship between you and your body gets disconnected. I always tell people, reducing the engrams in the first four layer is making friends with your body. Making friends with your body, because you don't know how we are abusing the body. Understand? If you are having overweight, it is directly connected to some of these engrams. When you feel emptiness inside, lonely, you start feeling it. Sometime you start feeling it by food or by drinking. Any one thing. Every single thing happening in your life is directly connected to some engram. Removing these engrams, I can say, is making friends with your body. Making friendship with your body. I can say this is the best way to heal. The other day, I received a big letter and a report from one of our devotees in USA. She came to our program maybe 2 years ago. Of course, the same meditation which we are going to do now, she did that meditation. She had a tumor in the Muladhara, root center. She had 3 times surgery. She herself is a doctor. But again and again, the tumor was growing in the same place. She came and she was doing this meditation, which we are going to do today. And she was weeping uncontrollably during the meditation. I tried to tell her, please relax, but it was uncontrollable. Anyhow, after the meditation, I asked her, what is the problem? She said that I suddenly again relived the guilt, the young age she has been abused by some of the close relative, some physical abusing, maybe sexual abuse. She said that suddenly that samskara opened up, that guilt opened up. I relived. That is the reason I am not able to control. I was uncontrollable. Please forgive me, Swamiji. I said, that's okay. Let it leave. Reliving is relieving. Understand? Consciously, reliving is relieving. And you will be surprised. Even of course, I am surprised. It was, of course, I know that relieving heals, but this is very miraculous. It really happened. And she says, after that relieving, after that meditation, within a month the tumor disappeared and never came back. Now at least 1.5 years over. Did not come back. I was shocked. I said, of course I know relieving heals, relieving the guilt, releasing all the samskaras heals. But this is really miraculous. The guilt which she created in the young age, not only about that the hatred about the, it has not only evolved as a hatred towards that person, it has evolved as hatred towards the self, towards herself and the part of that body part. So that hatred has become tumor and sickness. When that engram was released, when that guilt was released, when she became pure, when the guilt has left her system, suddenly she came back to health. The system came back to health. Understand, so many pains and sufferings, physical and mental illnesses, we are storing in our system in the form of some engram. Not only diseases, even disorders, obesity, or many other disorders, even those disorders are directly connected to some of our engrams. Working on the first four layer engrams and releasing them, reliving them and relieving them will heal your system very powerfully. Understand? It is little strong method, little strong technique, but I tell you, it's at least 100 times powerful than any yoga, any kriya you can do. Because yoga or kriya heals, no doubt. It takes its own time. This is like directly attacking the root center, root cause of suffering. Yoga starts working on your physical body, exhausts all the tamasic engrams and heals you. Kriyas, the breathing techniques, they start working on your pranic layer, second layer, and releases the desire engrams, reduces the stress and starts healing. But this method, the meditation techniques, straight away works on your fourth layer. You can work only maximum up to fourth layer. Beyond that, your logic cannot travel, your effort cannot do anything. Beyond that, only the master's presence can do any job. Anyhow, you can work up to the fourth layer. The meditation technique straight away works up to the fourth layer and heals you. That is why it will be so powerful. You need complete involvement, interest. You need to put your whole attention and awareness into the technique. If you can go into it and come out, you will see miracles happening inside you. Understand? If you don't know the science of miracle, you will be making accidents. If you know how to use your inner space, you will be making miracles. If you don't know how to use your inner space, you will be making accidents. Both are beyond your logic. Miracle and accident, both are beyond your logic. If the effect is favorable to you, desired by you call it miracle. If the effect is not desired by you, if it is not benefiting you call it as accident. In your inner space, if you know how to use, you will be constantly making miracles. Purifying the inner space is plan for miracles. If you don't know how to use, you will be constantly creating accidents, because you will be attracting the same frequency incidents in your life, same frequency actions in your life. So this is a wonderful truth which you need to internalize. Not only internalize, experience. By entering into the process, understand? I don't even want to use the word meditation technique for what we are going to do today. Today we are going to do two things. One is process. Maybe the second one can be called as meditation. The first one cannot be called as meditation, because It's more like reliving, going into all the things about which you are afraid, all the things which frightens you, facing them, living them, reliving them. I call this as relieving. Reliving is relieving. And we will enter into meditation technique. Very powerful technique which you can carry and practice in your home every day. Can anybody become the master, or he is the chosen one? Nobody else needs to choose you. You need to choose you, that's all. Understand, fortunately masters are not chosen democratic way. Nobody need to vote for you. All you need to do is, you need to vote for you, that's all. You need to choose you. Nobody else need to choose you. Just decide consciously, from today I am going to live the reality, the truth of my being. That is the decision. You have become master, that's all. I always tell people, when I say I became enlightened on a particular day, do not think something has happened in my system. Of course, something has happened, but that is not the actual main thing I want to convey. First thing, what happened? Very consciously I decided, let me leave my enlightenment. Because I decided, as an after effect, as a side effect, something has started happening in my body and mind. But people are always thinking, first that experience should happen, then you will decide. No. First the decision has to happen, then experience happens. So nobody else needs to choose you. Just you choose yourself. That is the best thing. Fortunately, there is no election for choosing the masters. In yesterday's meditation, I felt strong concentration between the eyebrows and vibration in the spine. Is this normal? Yes. Wonderful. You really had a good meditation. Vibration in the spine means the part of the Kundalini energy gets awakened. That is good experience. Somebody has written a question in Tamil. I may not be able to answer that, so I'll answer the other questions. Here, some of the questions, more like a personal healings, you can come and ask me, the energy darshan. I'm answering the questions which are directly related to the subject I have spoken. Swamiji, I would like to know the purpose of our life, our world, our universe and our God. If you know the purpose of your life, all the other three will automatically you will be able to understand. If you know the purpose of, here you are asking.